And hello, folks. Welcome back to Golf with Your Friends Editor. Got a decent response out of my my first water hop course. So I've ahead and decided to start on a new one. It's kind of a funky style, of course, to play on. It's because of, like, but for whatever reason, there's always like a little bit of inconsistency, like between the hops and whatever angle you come off at. You know, just gotta build things to account for that. But yeah, had lots of fun with the last one. I'd try out a new one. Got a couple basic concepts laid out already. Now, gonna try and start out pretty simple. Kind of get increasingly more complex and more unforgiving as you go along. It's nice just having something faster paced. It's pretty simple. Got to time your jumps properly. Well, we got sort of a maze type thing. Same concept, just got to time your jumps from section to section. Bam, pretty easy to hole in one. Trying out alternate version of the jumping between different sections, where instead of like upright triangles, we got these on their sides, which are a little bit harder to judge. And of course, you can change out right angles, so on. Trying to come up with stuff I haven't done yet. One of the things I tried was these gravity shifts, like alongside the waterways. Let's put this around real quick. So, unfortunately, if you put the waterways at an angle, doesn't really affect anything. Your ball will always go in the upwards direction. Right now. It's always awkward figuring out the correct angle for this. Yeah, if you you combine the gravity shift with waterways, it's similar to if you actually combine two different gravity shifts of like opposing angles. Like, you'd think they'd cancel each other out, but in fact what they end up doing is this in between section actually carries you upwards. Quickly demonstrate that. Ran into that issue a number of times on Broken Lands, building that. An interesting property. That's what it carries you along. Yeah. Lifts you upwards. Slowly falls down. But it's a similar effect if you, like, combine these at odd angles with the waterways here. Not tried having it straight down, though. I think that might actually be beneficial to the jumps, now that I think about it. Normally, when you try and jump in this, in waterways, has a tendency to your jumps bit, like, your ball kind of has to be positioned just right in order to get an optimal jump in the waterway. Having your ball constantly being pushed down might actually help out a bit. That. Let's see at that. If it's actually beneficial, then we might include it. Gotta do a bit of science. Figure out things I have not done yet. Second pathway. Have spider for comparison. Just like that. Sort of get a sense of how much difference, if any, it has on the ball. Yeah, I can barely make that. Get a decent height, spam click that. Like roughly the same height, maybe a little bit lower. I guess that would be a way to keep the ball from going too high if I want to limit their height. Kind of helps stabilize the ball a little bit. It's super beneficial though. I'll keep it in mind. But yes, so working on this hole, just changing the ball direction around. It's a little awkward figuring out the par for these. You know, the less forgiving a hole is, the higher the par should be, but all technically hole-in-one-able. That's the way I design them. Swap you. Angle. There. Normally the way I increase the difficulty from segment to segment is reducing the size or the space in between each jump you have to make. I want to give a little bit of extra space after these corner jumps, since you are changing your viewing angle as well. Don't think I want that there. Because I'm pretty sure a person couldn't normally make that jump. So I'll have to test that one out. And I'll figure out a good, like, aesthetic change I could make this. I want it to look a little bit different from the first one. Try to find stuff that looks good with the waterways. Suppose I should have platform there. Go. Get too far to the right on this one. It's impossible to make the jump. Yeah. I might include an outer wall, at least one on the right hand side. Yeah. Sort of account for that. There's more of an issue on this side. Of course, I could just alter the position of this, keep you from going too far to the left. That should actually fix the issue. Much further. How about there? Of course, it could be that I'm just not getting enough height on my jumps. Over. Ah. I was gonna like double or spam click some of these. Actually make them. No, still not making that one. Alright, we'll try putting the wall on. That helps at all. Back to snap. that one doesn't consistently doesn't seem to work. That. This is lined up. Wrong one. There's always the possibility that the player will purposefully hit their wall at an odd position. Ah. You know, screw themselves over. Ah, worked that time. Okay. Ah, didn't work. Getting there. Might be a good idea that happens at its previous position. So, the time we did make it, there wasn't quite enough time to adjust for the new angle. Pull this over. Just a couple of spaces. Not quite. First time we had trouble with that. Scooch me. Test these every time you get a new one. If it works as intended. That's a bit of an issue. Chime would change directions. Just knocking our ball out. That's at a weird angle, isn't it? 180. Ah, that's probably why. Okay. I'm sure that fixed it. I think I'll try on these first jumps, since making them taller. Have something like that. give it a little bit more leeway. Have the ones towards the end the shorter. Ah. That one's still giving me trouble. Height there, I guess. Ah, close. I wonder what's preventing us from getting that one. Ah, over the wall. Should be aligned same way. Oh, come on. Get another fight. Position should be identical to these. I might try extending Zala's wall. This one's over. Overhang the side a little bit. Oh, come on. It's not knocking me the way I want it to. Not sure why. Oh, those first ones are always so consistent, man. This one is. It might help if I extend that section before the jump a little bit. Ah. Always eats my jump. Let's give that a shot. Also have to extend this a little bit, I suppose. Switch everything over a little bit. I suppose it was the case for most jumps in general. You want like five spaces between like each jump you have to make. Gives your ball time to stabilize, and that way it won't eat the jumps constantly. Try. I should just delete this hole. Keep coming back to that on accident. Over. Oh, that worked for a second there. Definitely need a certain amount of speed. That to work. Okay. Let's try adding one of these walls on the other side. That's probably just going to end up blocking the player's vision. Just about. Hopefully it'll be alright. Gotta extend this out a little bit. Four wide, approximately. All right, let's give that a shot. Ah, interesting. The first jump never works, but the second one does. Thank you. okay. This wasn't the way I wanted it to work, but it worked. Changing the direction of the ball, in general. Risky thing to do in this. Because your ball inevitably bounces around within the canals. Up, sending me off at odd angles. Shame there's not really any good barriers I can put up that you can see through. I want to maintain visibility as much as possible. Okay. Let's just extend this whole section. See if that does anything. I am curious. That was interesting. For some reason I was able to jump pretty early on there. Think it helps at all if I the height of this walls, maybe it would. Let me check that real quick. For this, these all one high. And like the optimal height is just one high. These things. There's gotta be a better way. Grasping at straws here. Slight adjustments to its position will do something. Just feels like that. The first time I jump, every time, it's guaranteed. I whiffed both shots there. That's weird. Okay, worked there. That might be good enough. Gotta scooch everything else over again. Has to a certain level of reliable. Gonna be a little bit of inconsistency. Okay, let's try that. I'll probably make another, like, easier hole early on. Aw, oh, come on. The holes I have are more mid-range. I need something, like, super easy. Just as a demonstration. New folks. Pretty happy with this though. Got good visibility to it. Ah. And those walls are like a slight annoyance. Not too bad. Try and give you a good view of your ball if I can. Oh, come on. I don't like the toughness, though. Not an easy course. I include a little bit of a wall right there. Oh, yeah, we made it. Oh, come on. Takes a couple tries to get it over. Extending this helps at all. Have to make it over these walls. sure why it's not working. These first two are just so consistent each time. And the others are just kind of... Oh. Not working out. Oh, come on. I'll just have to extend it like I did the other one. That helps at all. See how that plays out. Be nice if there was, like, I don't know, a spot I could place my ball. You know, do later parts of a hole. Have to play through the beginning each time. Ah. Weird, it keeps bouncing around. Bounces in loops. Oh. Oh, that's interesting. Actually make two bounces there. Got the assistance. The upper angled piece. Oh. Alright, so that's one thing I do need to count for. Jumping up top. If I can do it, then someone's gonna do it. Someone else is going to do it quite frequently. Alright. Something right here. Put in that spider. Accidentally bounced ourselves out a couple times over this wall. We do kind of flail at this point. Trying to make the initial jump. Kind of making this whole segment a lot more bulky than I would like. Having to put in extra walls for stuff. Made it. Hey! Worked out. Gotta make this final segment nice and smooth. come on. Ate my jump again. Oh, I actually bounced back into the first lane. Oh. Eh. I want to include a wall on the other side then. Not a problem. I hate to add more walls. Final jump should be fine, though. I killed your momentum by that point. You have to spam, get over the wall like you do for others. Maybe I can shorten that wall a little bit. Another issue I have to account for. Alright. Ah. Have to be much more bulky. Oh, come on! Oh, of course. Get ourselves out. Let's see. Can I reduce the height of these a little bit? I go there, should do. Limbed all out a little bit. There. It's one thing I think would help a lot of this is just increasing the space in segments. Ah. Right. So add in one of these over here. Nice super thin one. One-ish. Turn it. that way. We'll run into the end of this. They're all getting knocked down. Nice and aligned. Not an ideal position for that. Build it down. Good idea. Because they can hit their ball like right at the edge. There. Oh, it's okay at this position. Out of that a little bit. Yeah, should be fine. Okay, we got it. This is rough. Hard accounting for all those weird bounces. Let's see. Do you think I'll scoot you this back a little? Those. Give like an extra space for that jump. That's acceptable. All right. So what is a basic starter hole to put on here? Not overly reminiscent of starter holes. Like a nice warm-up hole. Something forgiving. Do a basic portal. Just the first jump sends you back onto the waterway. Don't have to do much canals like we did previously. A bit lazier, but it works. not that interested in spending a ton of time on it. Sure, there's no way Fallout somehow missed the portal. Pretty confident they can make a tile jump. Yes, okay. Interesting, why is that not centered? It's odd dimensions, I guess. Nice and guaranteed that they'll fall in. That's fine. Let's have the out above. And then we'll give it a little bit of a house corner you have to make. be a sufficient starter hole. Oh, wrong way. Negative. Make sure it's in a good position. Or, you know, player one fling, like, outside of the portal area. I think that should be good, though. To pretty it up a little bit. Like, I'll have to lower the point a little bit. That, or I could just that there. That way we won't have that issue where we get caught on the edge. No? Ah, still got caught on the edge. Every once in a while you get a weird bump. So now I have all the end holes set up so far. Bit of a... suppose that might fix it, actually. Shot. Not like hitting it dead on, you're rolling over this curve. Yeah, it's much smoother. Alright. I'll probably make another, like, version of this kind of hole, but it'll have, like, the fake-outs. So, like, it'll have jumps that'll actually send you, like, back to the outer rings. Ah, come on. Hard to make this final one. Okay, there we go. If you're not paying attention, it'll knock you the wrong way. Don't do enough fake outs. Give this one another shot. Oh. Saved it there. Alright, yeah, this is reasonably consistent. Oh. How we go. Surprised I have enough speed there. The hole. he's in. That's the right position. I don't really like these walls the way I have them set up. I'll have to figure out something that looks good. Something space-ish themed. Yes. Next hole. That. About aesthetics a little bit later on. Want the whole functionality worked out. Keep that all fresh. Right. So I do more of like an upwards climb using the jumps. But like that vertical level. Honestly, that vertical hole on the first water hop course was probably my favorite. All the weird angle of that. Had lots of fun with that one. Like a 5-ish. And width. If this works as is, with more spacing. Let's see. 5, 6. Actually, that's how I did the previous one. Was I had a bit of an angle to it. Spaced out each height segment. I have to push this up somehow to keep it fresh. quite making that. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Have the first one where you can go straight up. Hey there, Mr. Joe. Sorry you're playing Risk of Rain earlier. How's that going? Any more characters unlocked? Gonna play with Ron last stream, but I guess having computer troubles. So, got Mercenary, cool. Curious if you prefer the melee style. Akrid and the captain. Or do you have Rex? Ah, cool. Hey, he's a bit of a pain to get. Takes a few tries. Yeah. Working a little bit on unlocking their alternate abilities. I tried for a while to get one of Mercenary's alternate abilities, but like, it requires you to do whatever that the alternate game mode is, like without taking damage. Fucking obnoxious. Yeah, command is great. Command is just a preferable way to play. Search around so much for random chests. You don't know if they'll even be where you're looking. Yeah. I pretty much got all of the artifacts. We can do like challenge runs if we want to. Yeah. I thought I'd gotten them all like previous time I played, but I apparently missed a couple. The majority of the Oh really? You've just been doing easy so far? Yeah. The majority of the artifacts just like make the game harder. Normal. I guess you still have your old, or you got a new monitor, didn't you? With your new computer? I'm not sure you're using like your old monitor plus a new one or what your setup is. Both new? Okay. I say if they're both new, they shouldn't be that hard to see. I don't know what type they are, if they're proper gamer monitors or not. Ah, yeah. Usually pretty good about spotting them. I use the radar a lot. Yeah. Yeah, I never bother with the radar unless I'm like multi. I have like the extra slot. Of course, I'm a lot more used to the maps than you are, I'm sure. So I kind of know where most stuff actually spawns. Like, consistent, like, possible spawn positions for stuff. I'm sure it's especially annoying on that that one level before the final boss where there's just actually broken chests laying around. So every time I've actually beaten the final boss, it's been like me using the Thunder build, which is OP. I think I've only beaten Mithrix like two or three times. Thunder build? Oh yeah. When you go with the Royal Capacitor with the Lightning Bolt. Plus some Jesters of the Drowned and Fuel Cells, which I'm guessing you haven't unlocked Gesture of the Drowned yet, because that's an obnoxious one to unlock, but it's super, super good, super useful. I think for Jester of the Drowned, you have to, like, knock, like, 20-ish those long-ranged crabs off the map. I think you have to do it on like a specific map as well. I don't know if they changed the requirements for it or not. But... you end up sitting on one map for a very long time. Just trying to get that. But yeah, the Gesture of the Drowned is the one that makes your Q item activate automatically. And, like, halves its cooldown. That way you can activate the, whatchamacallit, the lightning bolt, just like by looking at a guy. Yeah, it's a lunar item. Yeah. But you have to complete the achievement to actually unlock it. It's the Nautilus shell looking thing. It's the only lunar item I'd ever bother getting. Outside of very rare circumstances. Oh yeah. Best of the Coil Dagger are super nice in general. Also, Will-O-Wisp. Like 30 Will-O-Wisps, everything dies. Nice just going into a level and killing one guy, then just watching the chain reaction. Can't quite recall, like, last time I checked the base damage, you guys. Yeah. That's the coil in general, is just good at doing that. Oh, I'd say Testicle is strong for anybody. In my experience. It's the fact that you're dealing damage without having to touch anyone. I guess it depends what items you have alongside it. Got any crowbars or whatever? I don't know, I'd have to look. Not. Oh, one way rod. Ten glasses. Yeah. You know, having crits in general help a lot. Yeah. Let's see, was it I got the Huntress alternate abilities recently. And her alternate, like, main attack is kind of interesting. Because it's more or less the same thing. Like, it shoots the arrows, but it's in, like, bursts of, like, three. But, its whole thing is that if you get crits on it, it'll double your number of shots. Which is pretty cool. Also, like, her alternate special ability, where instead of, like, shooting down like a circle of arrows, it fires like you have three shots of like a sniper, so like hit it from across the map with that really easily. The spider mines are nice, like his normal mines. Well, the thing about the engineer is like the normal mines actually can do more damage, but they have to be set down for like a second or two, or else they'll just do normal damage. Yeah, like the spider mines aren't nice just because they're, you know, they activate faster and they have a good range to them. Yeah. Well, what I really liked was Artificer's alternate abilities. Her alternate special. Like, instead of the flamethrower, it just, like, launches her up into the air, which is fantastic for her, just because she can hover around. You just, like, launch yourself 20 feet up in the air and, like, float around from there. Quite a lot of damage that way. Also, her ultimate, like, main attack, like, instead of, like, throwing fireballs, is throwing, electric balls, have a larger AoE to them. It's basically trading, like, damage over time for AoE, which is often worth it. Get more guys that way. Her alternate, like, secondary wasn't really good, though. Like, instead of throwing the giant round balls, you, like, shoot, was it just, like, a bolt? Which, the benefit of that is it fires straight. As opposed to the ball, which is, like, shorter ranged, and it, like, curves towards the ground. But the ball is just so nice because it has this huge damage area, and it hits things while it's traveling through the air. Ooh, almost. I've enjoyed playing Artificer. A little bit weaker, She doesn't have, like, a lot of defense to her, but... Beyond that, her general, like, yeah, apparently every class is damage. Yeah, it's pretty similar. It's just like split between like their attack rate. I think the main difference is that the melee classes tend to have more armor. Like the mercenary has like high base armor, which like you don't get that for any other class. It's a good bit of tankiness. Kind of funny, Akrid's jump. It's because, like, if you get a bunch of goat hooves, that increases the distance of that jump. Just go for, like, flying. Anyway, to prevent getting one shot. I mean, it kind of depends what's shooting you. Like enemies with items, depending upon the item, may always one-shot you. Best ways in general to avoid getting one-shot is, you know, don't get hit, for one. You know, dodge the shots. There's a few, you know, abilities that, like, prevent you from taking damage altogether. Yeah, I mean, just, Tough Time Spear, want your infusions, want the shield generator, plus, the Topaz Brooch. Nice thing about the shield is that it's like percentage based off your health. Means that as you get more infusions, it will also increase the strength of your shield. Also means that you have to get more topaz brooches to keep your overshield up. Like, as high as... Oh, yeah. The main reason you want to add the shield is to have more overshield with the topaz brooch. It takes that into account. Yeah, well, healing is nice, but... healing doesn't prevent you from getting one shot. Healing prevents you from getting, like, five shot. But the great thing about an overshield, like Topaz Brooch, is, like, healing rarely becomes a factor. Like, unless you're fighting, like, Mithrix, where, like, you know, there's not a bunch of, like, adds you can kill along the way. Like, then healing becomes more of an issue. But, like, outside of that, it's like, as long as you're killing, like, random enemies, that's, like, refilling your overshield oftentimes, like, faster than you're, like, taking damage, unless, you know, you're getting one shot. That just means you need to, like, add more HP. There's also that one, like, armor item, which, like, is a flat damage reduction, but I don't recommend getting that. The damage you receive scales, like, way faster than that. Like, keep up on. Which is my experience. You'd need, like, you know, crowbar numbers of those. It'd be worth it. Honestly, the main reason I get healing is, like, for the healing skulls. As an extra, like, method of damage output. And then, like, the main healing item I would get in general is the scythes. Like, they give you a good amount of health. Just off of getting crits. I mean, like early on, I'd probably say the best healing item would be, like, the medkit. In most cases, just because, you know, it's mobile. Yeah. Fungus is great if you, like, have a bunch of them and you're, like, an engineer. You'll move around a lot. I also get them as wreck sometimes, but... Like, outside of engineer, it's usually preferable to have, like, mobile healing. Yeah. Well, leech seed is nice, but if you can't, if you have the choice between leech seed and a scythe, go for the scythe. Like, as long as you have, like, crits available. It's, like, over double the amount of healing per hit. An interesting way I can mix this one up. Yeah. Like, crits are, like, one of the first items I usually get. Like, get a form of healing. And then, like, throw the rest into crits until I have 10. Stacking magazines. I mean, like, there's generally not that much use to mines, so no. Like, you do the same amount of DPS, just with your regular attack. Enjoy your editing, sir. Yeah. Yeah, it mostly uses mines just on awkward terrain. You're, like, trying to control a point. Can't see over the edge or whatever. Or, you know, if there's enemies following behind you, but you don't want to turn around. Let me know if you ever want to just co-op randomly. Around. Try spiraling this in. Oh, the right here, I think. Make it a little bit different from the previous tower you had to climb up. Maybe add in a couple of obstacles. Not a whole lot of room for obstacles. Should be fine. Also, naturally, we're going to be adding in explosives underneath the goals for this. And the trademark at this point. Probably forgo the waterways. This one. All right, there. IDN. Let's see. Right. Down. Add that on. Change size. And I turn off. Oh, snap. Out again. All right. And how this particular two starting is nice and see the flag that way. Let's give it a shot. Now these are fairly forgiving jumps. Can fall off the edge there, but it's not easy to fall off. Oof. Changing camera angle's the main issue, I think. Almost made it. So good. Interesting. I don't like that, actually. I think I'll make that a feature. Right, so if you miss that jump, let's have it just lift you back up to the poop section here. Cool. Pretty cool. Bend it out slightly. One, six, two. Yes. And of course, I'll have to put a bunch of hinges on these. How many blocks actually share this color scheme? Green and dark gray. Looking at some of the other wall pieces, see if they work, but white just kind of fits. Like how I have these jumps staggered, like hit the ceiling of the next level. Come on. There we go. A little bit narrow jumps. There we go. Back around. Oh, and out we go. Last jump, it's a little bit hard. I might need to extend out the last segment there a little bit for the goal. Ball has time to stabilize and make another jump. Come on. Come on. There we go. scooch this all out more. Add some walls around this, mostly for aesthetics. With that, kind of want to adjust it a little bit harder. Steadily increase the distance of the jumping platform. Next level. Back around we go. There we go. And out we go. Sucks my camera angle. Usually zooms in. Hey, got it. This one out of the way. Oh. Final test run. I should be good with this one. Jump there. Oh, over the wall. Have to increase the size of the wall. I haven't had any issues with the ball falling out, like over these canal edges. See? It's relatively straight. There we go. Probably more forgiving than some of the earlier holes. I'm happy with that. And this was. It's come a long way, though. What shall our next hole? Kind of want to use the targets. Playing around with targets earlier. So I have just like a jump you can't normally make. Target down in the middle. Bounce off of it. And go. What am I grabbing here? What that was. Gotta figure out. Dimensions for that jump, though. Okay. So, can't make it normally. Can you make it if I jump? Yes. Okay. I could actually increase that distance by a smidge more. Let's try that real quick. Yes. Okay. Cool. That works. You won't make that if you just go straight. Though, you go forward with enough power, you might be able to make it. One and a half. Oh, okay, a little less. A one. Alright, yeah. You won't get enough height that way. Important part. And if you full power, you shouldn't make it, right? Yes, okay. We're clear on that. Alright. So then we can just add in some corners here. Have them do a series of jumps like that. Facing up. Yes, okay. Down to 180. Of course, I could do something similar to that previous hole where I had it end on like a standard one of these. You kind of have to guess the timing to jump. Less forgiving in that fashion. I go a further distance this way. Combine the two concepts. Ooh, make it that time. Okay. Not always enough to just jump. Oh, okay. If I do this, I'll probably end up making markers for when to jump. Made it. So we'll want that further out. Rish. Roughly equidistant on the other side. Ah. Oh, that's not as consistent as I would like. let's see. Let's, I think it was one bar we had. Sure, that almost worked. Make sure it doesn't work. Okay, still doesn't work. Good. Means that any amount of jump that we put into this should still get you up to the next level. Yes, okay, cool. Oh, bad jump. Ah. I drew a bit too early. Cool. And okay. Put the exit. Actually, I should also add a couple of those on. Just to make sure the ball is straightened out. There's one issue I ran into last time I tried this. Was you need a little bit of just a little section before the boost. Otherwise, the ball won't be completely straightened out. It'll be like bouncing around a little bit. Just from making that corner. Shot. Oh, yeah, early. Alright, cool. Again, definitely need to include markers. Let's see. Last time I used markers. Update that. 90. There-ish. And jump spot on my previous setups were actually right here, right between these two lines. Find is where you want to aim the vast majority of the time. Just around. And do the same thing here. Right between those points. That should be a good indication. And cross. Oh. Ah. A little bit too late. Okay. Kind of scooching this back a little bit. Thank you. Ooh. Not quite. You really got to jump off of that one. Up that time. Gotta spam click, I guess. Spam clicking. Early that time. Hard timing. It's eating my jumps. See, my time it all helps. Oh, overshot it. Okay. Closer to where I wanted. Like there. Okay, that was good. That's what I was after. All right. So instead of doing the same exact thing again, I'll try mixing it up a little bit. Which this is. And 9 points apart. Adjusting the angle here. See where that lands us. Might be a little bit consistent. Worry about, but I can just change the position of it closer to this thing. Because I can't just make the receiving. After that jump, just wider, compensate for the consistency. Oh, nah. Didn't quite get it. Cool. Not too late. Early. Oh. think that works. Gotta figure out a position to put this in. Five. Get up pretty nicely. Center, cool. Now we can widen this out. 1.5 there and there. Give plenty of space to receive. I hope it's at an acceptable height. Might need to move it slightly lower. Ending. Overshot at that time. Interesting. All right, that worked out. Now we just need another corner. Itch. Need to burst that. Lengthen it out. Okay. -1. 5. All right. There, flip around. Head. Couple of indicators here for a jump. Could do one more jump here, I suppose. Or a completely different style of target. Ah, yes, we'll do a 45 degree here. These will sound. Up. And we'll see if we can get to jump up to a higher level. So overshot it again. Huh. Increase the size of this target. Down. Too early. Dude. whatever reason, I missed that one a lot. I think it might help if I stay perpendicular. Like, keep my camera perpendicular. See the jump spot. More precisely. Ah, too early. Indicators need to be earlier. This one. By the time I get to them, too late. Here. Or two. Pretty narrow, pretty narrow timing to jump. Come on. He's in trouble. As I'm like overshooting that sometimes. Undershoot. Oh, there we got it. All right, worked out. Okay, let's make sure. Okay, it's kind of a guaranteed thing to bounce you up there, it seems. Isn't what I want. But I do want. To knock you up higher. Do it. Oh. Huh. Why is that not working all of a sudden? That. That should count for any funkiness. Ah. Kind of going off at a weird angle on that one. Yeah. Increase the run up to it. Size the ball more. It might help if I shrunk this down a bit. A narrow inch. Should still line up fine on the first shot. Yeah. Maybe it's a better. Oh. Early. Readjust those markers. One thing though, I would like this target to be set up such that if you hit your ball, or if you you don't jump, send you like straight backwards, but if you do jump, land you up top. Be a good idea to shrink this down as well. Oh. 5.25s. Some of that going. Seven five. have the lead up dinner. Not to worry about any bounce on the ball. Jumped over that time. So that time we just kind of got into a bit of a death spiral. Back and forth. Size of this. No, I gotta think about this. It's kind of why I have these diagonals here. That way, if you miss the jump, it'll send you downwards. Harder to do it this way. That a shot. Get more distance out of it. Alright, I can make it without some jump. Like? No, okay. Make it without pressing jump. If I jump off this, I should be able to get more height. Up a little more. See if that works. There we go. But I can't get it without jumping, right? Okay. Still have to jump. Right. see here. Okay, that works as well. Actually better that way. Got a little bit too much speed on the previous one. Reliable. I think it works too well. Add a little bit of a gap. All the fall off. Well, I guess if you don't do anything for long enough, fall will technically. Can't just AFK. Weird as that would be. Enough wave, we've lost necessary distance to make the jump. There we go. Okay. Then we'll just finish that off with. Ooh, perfect, yes. One of these. Reduce the target size. Like earlier on in the level. Hit the target and bounce over to another section. Probably want to widen this out. And back to one. Works. Pull down, okay. Okay. It works. On to the goal. That lines up quite nice, doesn't it? Grab one of those finisher blocks. All rolls up, all nice. Let's give it a shot. I guess that's a reasonable amount of unforgivingness for it. Doesn't normally knock you off, but it weird bounces in there. I'm not... First couple jumps, that's just the hard part of this one. The rest is pretty easy. There's not too early. Early. Ah, overshot it. Wow. Okay. I've actually overshot that. Need to increase the target size. One is 1.4. Same for this. Eating my jumps there. Enough height. Yeah. Let's try scooting this apparatus out a little. Distance there. Right. Cool. I'm gonna jump again. I'm not getting the height for that last one. There we go. Think we'll include something on the end of this to sort of guide the ball inwards. Yes. Like 25-ish. Just gotta scooch this forward slightly. That's right. No? Okay, a little bit more. 6. Alright. It's a nice, smooth run into the hole. Thank you. I bounce. Probably add a couple of walls around there. Yeah. Let's see, grab a couple of you guys. That's adequate. Need a wall on either side just to extend the wall. I guess I might be able to get away with this thinner area. If I tried that already or not. Okay. A little bit of a gap. This should work out. Might even be good to remove this wall here. Not without the wall. Sometimes. Potentially get some weird jumps. I looked up. I think that's working out pretty reliably so far. Haven't been able to time any funky jumps so far. Give it one more try and say it's good enough. Good enough. Reasonably challenging hole. Contend with that. That's our sixth hole. Brainstorm some seventh hole concepts. We want some more explosives at some point. Those explosives were fun. Anyway, I think I'm done for tonight. I hope you folks had fun. I did. And I should be back tomorrow with something. Don't know what, but it should be something. Have a good night.